I'm so delighted, yet very humbled, to have this opportunity to be here in accepting this award. I greatly thank Anita Board Institute and those at the Institute, and especially those with whom I have worked for the past 20 years. For my colleagues at IBM, from the colleagues at IBM, a truly great place for ingenuity and innovation, to faculties from Australia, France, Singapore, and my college advisors in China. So many people have been instrumental in my growth as a technologist, giving me the chance to stand here. As I look back over the past years, I'm utterly amazed by how far I have crossed to end up here. I grew up in a world that was just slightly different from the one that we are living now. I was born in a small city in China and went to school in small bare brick buildings without running water or electricity. But I was not content with being an ordinary school girl and destined to stay in my hometown and work at the local pharmacy, as my mother had suggested. I heard glimpses of power of science and technology, all of the wonders that filled through the radio broadcasts, proclaiming progress and innovation, inventions. To me, it seems so remote, yet so fascinating, a whole world out there to be explored. When I got into college in late 70s, after college education had just been restored, signifying the end of the Cultural Revolution, I felt so fortunate. I was among top 2% of the high school graduating class who were admitted by college, and was among only 10% who were women, who were female in my college class, because gender equality was certainly not a concern for college, and electrical engineering was not really meant for girls in the eyes of government planners. I was among some classmates who were 10 years older than me, who never had the opportunity for college during their prime time. Instead, they were sent to far-off work communes. I was lucky to be with them, and their hard work, determination, and appreciation of the last chance of school influenced me a lot in setting my life target. The college, with spatial dormitories, large classroom, very plain, large, just plain classroom, and libraries and laboratories with the computers, was just like heaven for me. I realized I could continue on this upward path of education only with two guiding principles: focus and risk-taking. At that time, I saw that without those two values, I would never be at the place where I was. I would never have had the opportunity to go on in the future and look through the lenses of technology. It became evident that there would be times when I have to make decisions without seeing light at the end of the tunnel, without clear resolution waiting for me at the final. However, without the sense of being challenged and the desire of conquering the challenges, there would be no path for progress and innovation. Years later, when I landed in France as a postdoc, the word focus seems to have true meaning. It would be a lie to say that the first few months were not a struggle. Being completely out of touch with the language, out of sync with the food and culture, and away from my family and friends was a huge adjustment. The only way to keep me up was to let the research work take front and center. Yet, there was some sort of determination in me that kept on saying, despite the circumstances, despite the fact that you have to work many times as hard as everyone else around you, you still have to see it through. My advisors in Nancy, Professor Jean-Paul Ladon, can testify the hours I spend in the lab, reading papers, deriving equations, writing and testing code, running experiments again and again, day and night. From this experience, it may seem almost a little discouraging to the future scientists and engineers and technologists, especially young women, who are disillusioned by the nature of the research and technology world. But I can tell you confidently that it is simply not true. While research may seem tedious, mundane at times, at the end of the day, the pursuit of innovation, the struggle for the remaining puzzle pieces that refuse to fit, is truly great. Technology research is also fundamentally about collaboration and interaction with people. It is about seeing a project molded and shaped by information from all different corners, measures and the techniques shared by the best and brightest from around the world. This became evident when I arrived at the IBM T.J. Watson Research Center in 1995. One of the largest industrial research institutes in the world, the IBM Research Center is filled with opportunities and novel ideas, swimming with Nobel and Fields Prize winners, all sharing together in the pursuit of new technology for the future and for the society. In year 2000, after I had worked on speech recognition technology for 14 years and had some success in developing advanced technology as well as commercial product, I felt as if speech recognition had reached a plateau in its statistical approaches. I did not believe that a new breakthrough can come from incremental improvement. So I had that proposal, as you just heard, and we achieved our goal through our accomplishment milestone. Of course, it was easy said, and it would be, if it was easy, it would have done long ago. There were many hurdles, because speech recognition and translation both are open-ended challenges. The most interesting part of the research with such an innovative target as speech-to-speech translation was taking the challenges that have yet to be conquered by human beings. And it was exciting through advanced technologies to take place in finding ways to revolutionize the way people around the world communicate with one another when they do not share a common language. Having so many high goals that we had to account for were very energizing to deal with on a daily basis. No day went by without new obstacles staring at me. Often I found myself in a position that after solving one technical difficulty, and 10 more were waiting for me to discover and to solve. Every day was a new experience. However, the results are rewarding. The potential uses of MASTO lay not just in human interactions, but also in tying together of our increasingly globalized society. For example, our technology has been deployed in places where it can help with the distribution of aid and humanitarian services to the local residents and remove conflicts caused by simply misunderstanding with language. The master technology, as you heard earlier, has been recognized by many institutions from around the world. Knowing that I played a central role in its development is really something special. I picture myself, again, sitting by an old radio, hearing through the buzz about new breakthroughs in medicine, in technology, and wanting a part of that when I grew up. At that time, that dream seemed impossible. And today, with the support and help of those around me especially my dearest and greatest colleagues at IBM, my IBM colleagues here. And by the way, among them, which is my husband, and today the dream is slowly taking shape. And you can all do that. Thank you.